almost heaven. West Virginia, Blue Ridge Mountains, Shenandoah River. Life is old there, older than the trees, younger than the mountains, growing like a breeze. Country roads, take me home to the place I belong. West Virginia, mountain mama, take me home. Country roads, I hear her voice in the morning.
Take two!
Dude, what are you doing?
That was 5 feet over!
Yeah, you gotta grab it!
Oh!
Hey,
not near the trees. It's just the tree scared me.
The champions are in the midst of their longest road trip of the season, 11 games long, and they wrap it up with 4 straight against the Quebec Capitals at Stade Canac in Quebec. The champions' playoff hopes were not completely dashed, but they needed wins against the Capitals, a powerhouse in the Can-Am League, and they needed them quickly. Down by 3 in the early going, Chase Harris required some medical
attention.
Shoulder? No. He got hit. Didn't mean to hit him.
Hit in the neck and the tail.
I don't know. Look at me. Look right there.
Because he comes flying by on this base with a skidding.
You all right?
Yeah.
Sure? Yeah. Hell of a tap.
Right there. What the hell happened there?
Get up, Bill.
Mark, what'd I tell you about peeing on the circuit breaker? What are we doing here? We're gonna hang out in the dark?
Yes. No, we're gonna play in the dark.
Everybody, hey, bring the bus, bring the cars. We're gonna put them out in the outfield.
It's just kind of scary. There's no lights. I don't know where everybody is. Somebody help me, please. This is my stuff. This is my helmet. Trying to find my bat. Didn't really do anything today, but didn't really work. He was put away because he didn't do anything today, so it's crazy in here.
This is crazy.
Yeah, look at this. We'd be in Venezuela, we'd be getting robbed. That's it right now. Wow. This is crazy.
Oh my God!
Hey, 5 minutes on the bus.
Let's go.
I'll be hot.
Let's lock your butts right now. Sorry, kids. Don't ever say that. It's only darkness.
Don't do crap.
Kids, which brings me to my next point.
Everybody's yes! Gonna see.
Oz, only man. That's freaking funny. Good for you, bro.
Oh.
Get the ball! Didn't work.
They got a light. I guess we'll play tomorrow.
in the daytime. It'd be like Wrigley Stadium.
It may not be Wrigley, but Stade Canac is a gem in its own. After the power outage the night before, Ottawa and Quebec resumed their game in the sixth inning.
With one out and a runner on second and Chase Harris against Sebastian Boucher in a full count is up high, ball four. Looks in, the 1-1, ripped up the middle over the head of Guillen, rolling to the wall in right center field. Here comes Soms to the plate, the throw on a couple hops is not in time. And Quebec takes a 5-4 lead. Here's the first pitch to Brown, grounded to short. Played by Mandalay to second, they get the force there and that's the ball game. 6-5, Quebec takes it.
Quick turnaround, just hours later, Ottawa looked to rebound in game two of the series with Jordan Kurikawa on the mound. With Jordan Kurikawa in his rhythm on the mound, Brian Portelli gave him some help.
I think first pitch, I took next pitch, threw a changeup down, and I got a fastball where I wanted it, and, you know, drove it.
It's the 1-1, and Portelli drives it into left center field. Back at the wall is McCohen. It is gone! Brian Portelli with a monster shot. Way out of this ballpark, and he's taken the lead for the champions in the fifth inning. Bick flies it out to right center field. Llewellyn's back to the wall. He stops there. This ball is gone. Daniel Bick goes oppo. He fires it out over the right center fence, and the solo homer has made it 2-0 Ottawa. Portelli laces it to left, down for a base hit. Boucher scores, they wave around Kohet. Here's the throw to the plate on one hop, the tag, not in time! Kohet slides around Tissenbaum, and it's 4-0 champions. Here's the pitch, Ungate loops it toward right field, this is dropping, and it's down for a base hit. It gets behind the right fielder Llewellyn, and Hungate's on his horse, around second, headed for third, turned toward White at second, the throw into third base is not in time. It's a stand-up triple for Michael Hungate. The right fielder leads off the inning, standing 90 feet away for Tyler Nordgren. The 1-0, ripped to the right side, base hit! Here comes Hungate to score. Nordgren with an RBI knock. 5-2 champions. The champions go back to the bullpen and have Danny Carella come out for the eighth inning. He's the setup man. Power outage was last night, but today the champions black out Quebec. They take the second game of the series by a score of 5-3. Baseball's routine allows for many things. When you lose, you can shake it off the next day. When you win, you can build momentum the next day. Ottawa would try to do that in game number 3 with Edelson Alvarez on the mound.
Gentlemen, welcome to Stade Canac in Quebec City. We got a solid matchup tonight.
Why do you think there's an owl, Mike? Come on. The predatory birds, they scare other birds away. So then they don't nest up in the rafters. Come on. I got a mic.
This is that's his personal footage right there.
If I'm going like this,
you sat down, what are you going on?
That's bad for business, fellas.
Hey, Danny asked me to.
You just walked in at the wrong time.
I do it. Do what Poppy says.
Ciao, Boosh. Want to say hi to anyone while you're over here?
Huh?
You want to say hi to anyone while you're over here?
You?
Yeah, mic'd up, man.
Oh, hey, what's up, man? How you doing, everybody?
Say hi to the kids.
Happy
belated
kids.
Birthday. Simone.
Run through! That boy, Googs! My toes are so cold right now.
Oh!
Out.
Fire.
Out?
Yeah, out. Like
no,
out.
You need out to be out of the dugout.
I had no idea you had the mic on.
You didn't know?
I had no idea.
Really? It's only been on since before the anthem. Bye.
See you, dude.
Good hack, Chase. Good boy. Oh, that's embarrassing. You have to edit that one out there, Carter. You're getting boxed for that. Coming down to say hi. You guys saw him foul that ball off, but I didn't watch where the ricochet went. It f***ing landed five feet from me. I know. Everyone's all dispersed. This is no fun. Everyone's usually sitting down.
I can't wait to ambush so many people with this mic on.
I'm choking on C's right now. What's going on?
You still play a lot of Fortnite?
Yeah, I probably will.
No, I'm saying like now.
Now? Nah, World of Warcraft.
World of what?
World of Warcraft.
You play that? Really? You play?
No.
Yeah, you do.
I play.
About to expose my man.
Exposure.
Vinny tell me the G in his name is silent, right? It's because he asked me how. I know, he asked me how do I pronounce his name. I go Guguletti. And he's like, no, it's Guletti. And I'm, he goes, the G is silent. I go, so if the G is silent, then it's Uletti, right?
My tortellini.
Hey, baby!
Look at him flipping his hair back. Look at him flipping his hair back like he cute. I can't even see that far. I don't have my contacts in.
I can't see without my contacts.
If there was one person on the team that you think that would end up being a serial killer, who do you think it would be?
I think we both want to say Scott, but we're also afraid to say Scott.
Yeah. Sometimes I look at him and I'm like, oh, he's mad at me. And
he's
I did nothing wrong.
I definitely.
What's up, man? How you doing? Oh, it ain't that cold. I really do score a lot of runs when I'm over here. So I know Jay about to get a hit right here. You don't throw 95. Oh, no? Okay, cool. Ever since I've been on the DL, these guys treat me different. I don't like it. Pineapples. Hey, I gotta stop eating. I'm getting fat. It's not a sunker, it's a sinker.
It's a sunker.
No, it's a sinker. No, Vinny blends in well, bro. I'm telling you. He plays like music like that. Everybody likes that vibes. He's super nice to everybody. But like, my man's just a psycho for real, bro.
One, two. Ripped down the first baseline. Fair ball into the corner. Llewellyn scores. They're going to wave home Ehrlich. He comes across. They have McCohen in a rundown. Kiowa tags him out to end the inning. But Quebec has scored two runs and take a 4-3 lead over Ottawa going to the top of the ninth. Champions were just a strike away from getting out of their eighth inning jam, but McCohen's triple down the right field line sealed the deal for the Capitals in the third game. This is going to be a big one for the champions. Their window to make the Can-Am League playoffs is slowly closing. Not only get through their drive to clinch a playoff spot, but try to play spoiler here in the words of Vinny Galletti earlier today and keep their playoff hopes alive. It's truly a battle of the titans on the mound between the champions and the Capitals today. For Ottawa, it's the right-hander Austin Crispin with an 8-9 record and a 3.81 earned run average. Now, Jake Hale said it in the pregame show, so did Mason Gentry, the host of the show. His record is not an indication of how he's pitched for the majority of the season.
He's gone out there, he's been a workhorse for us every single time. He goes out there, throw 125 if we need it, you know. He controls all of his stuff, you know, he's competitive in the zone, and, you know, whether he comes out on top, you know, or, you know, just lets it slip away, he always keeps us in the game. It's awesome to watch him pitch, you know. He just battles constantly, and he goes out there and gives us a chance every time he pitches.
It's always special. I mean, I always get to see some old fans that kind of saw me through here, and, you know, the crowd's always somewhat good. It's just the coziness, you know, everything's on top of you. It feels like the fans are right in your ear when they're cheering for you when you're for Quebec and against you. So they're kind of like the X factor of this ball team.
Sebastian Boucher knows it better than anybody. Stade Canac is a classic ballpark, and Capitals fans make it a harsh place for opposing teams. They packed the joint for Game 4 of the series.
Tonight. That's what I'm feeling.
Wow. Gotta love that Can-Am strike zone. Back! Back!
Did you see that the lights were on today at like 4:15, 4:30?
They wanted to make
They're not taking any chances tonight.
Yeah! I love it!
Viva in Quebec! Viva! Viva! We will roll you in for a double play. Oh, no. Oh, boy. That's not coming back. Catch that.
Oh, yeah! Speak of the devil. Yes, sir!
Oh, yeah. Smell ya. You won't pull one. Told you. He must have heard me. That was a good bat flip for an F9. Coco, he thinks I'm on drugs. Come on, hang one.
Yeah! Who called that?
Stay fair!
Yeah! Attaboy, Steve!
It's a two-run dong for Steve Brown. He scores Boucher from first, and he's given Ottawa the lead in the top of the fifth inning.
You calling another one?
Like he swung through it.
Yes! Oh! You did! Yeah, baby!
Oh my goodness, what a moonshot! He's just pounded it out of here. A solo homer makes it 4-2. This one was hit a mile out of Stade Canac.
Two for two. Hey, I got it. It's all in here. It's all documented.
Two for two, baby.
He got you twice.
Two for two, baby.
You all right? He stays right there.
He's...
Hey, focus, focus, focus. Settle down and focus, all right? Go right here, he stays out there. That's all you're worried about right now. Get out by out, make sure he stays right there, okay? Focus up, what are you guys going with first?
Who's up right now, Max?
Yep.
Fastball in or off? I say in, we'll go in.
Okay, play the four hole if you're gonna go in, okay? Make sure Oz and you know. Oz, play the four hole on this pitch.
Crispin looks over at the runner on first and Max Tissenbaum. Kicks and fires. White drills it down the left field line. Back at the wall is Hungate, reaches up, and it is gone. TJ White has done it again. His second homer of the evening propels the Capitals into a big lead, 6-4. Here it comes. Vic flies it into right field. Anchak camps underneath it and makes the catch. So Quebec takes it 6-4 over Ottawa. Another nail biter that doesn't go in the champion's way here at Stade Canac in Quebec.
Is that Carter?
It is Carter.
Jesus, what are you doing here, man?